Hey folks, this is Best in Slot and welcome to our first video of the brand new Southeast Asia Animal Pack. This is our animal showcase. I'm going to show you all eight of the brand new animals along with their babies. Now, we do have lots to cover. 2 minutes per animal max. I'm setting myself a limit. Let's get started. And we're going to kick things off with the second best of the pack, the rather incredible looking sun bear. Let's just stop right there for a second to look at the actual design. There it is. The sun bear is spot on. It was my favourite animal until recent changes. The long claws, the way the muzzle fades out and that coffee creamed colour into the face, the wrinkles above the eyes are really pronounced. And the really good thing about the sun bear, as well as that sort of underbelly texture there, is it's got this kind of, Oh, are you going to do it? Wait, bear with me, folks. Bear with me. It's good stuff. No, you're not. They've got this kind of lanky, long-limbed, weird look about them, which is very, very sun bear. It really is. And that's why they're such an interesting animal. Look how cute he is! Hello! Wait, what's your name? This is Abyasa. Abyasa, you're adorable. Yeah, best bear in the game for me. Really interesting looking. That really interesting patterning on the chest as well. That mottled, again, coffee sort of colour design. Everything's coffee colour to me. I don't even like coffee that much. Let's go check out the baby for a second. There he is, down there, doing baby bear things. As in, hiding from the camera. Kind of adorable, though, as you would expect. Just a small version. Oh, it's also a ghost, which is impressive. You know, oh my god. There he is, though. Very cute. Just a small sun bear. The chest marker hasn't come in yet, but the claws are there. The wrinkles aren't there quite yet, either. And you'd say the coloration around the muzzle hasn't quite pushed back above the eyes. But other than that, just a cute little sun bear. Now, before we move on to the next animal, we do have to wait and watch over here. Okay, and this is exactly why, folks. This is a brand new enrichment item. This is the hammock. And, oh god, the animation and the sun bear climbing into this hammock is probably my favourite thing in the entire game right now. So, let's watch it happen. The bear approaches. Let's make sure we get this in really nice lighting, shall we? That'll look good. Bear climbs up, grabs onto the lower branch, clambers up slowly. Little hesitant. Oh, stretching those limbs out, trying to safely get across. Easy does it. And then, poof! And then he just chills. He just lies there, scratching himself, looking around, chilling, having a grand old time. It's a really good way to check out the details on that chest marking as well. There you go, folks. The sun bear. Really great animal. I'll show you the Zoopedia super quickly for this. I'm not going to talk through it. I'm just going to, if you want to, you know, pause it and take a look at the details, you can do just that. And Binturong species enrichment, which is really cool. That's going to be a really nice mixed habitat, I think. Let's move on. Number two on our list is the Come on, buddy. It's the proboscis. Oh, my god. He's gone flying. It's the proboscis monkey. Looks basically like we expected from the screenshots, really. Looks really good. Has the, you know, that dark sort of patterning above the eyes. Has that humongous nose is really the most important thing. Has that sort of pot belly as well that you'll see down here. I'd like to find one on the ground so I can actually see what's going on here. There you go. Hello, pal. Yeah. Oh, there he goes. Shoving it in there. You can see the nose actually wobbles as he eats and reacts to his hand moving. Look, his hand moves up and the nose bends upwards as the hand pushes it out of the way. That is attention to detail, ladies and gentlemen. He's got those wrinkles around the eyes again. It's a very wrinkly pack, this. It must be said, the Southeast Asia pack. I love the colour variation. He really sticks out, I think, amongst the other... He's pooping. They always wait till this video for pooping. they really stick around out amongst the other primates, I would say, just because of this white and orange coloration, which is really, really surprisingly vivid in-game. And of course, the huge honker, as they would say. They want to see the baby. There's the baby. Now, the baby's being silly. There we go. Baby? Oh. I'm just going to zoom in. The females have much smaller noses. They look more akin to what the baby noses look like. You can see this one is kind of there, but it's not quite pushing through quite yet. It's not covering the mouth at this point in time. But all the colorations there, the darker above the eyes, and then the lighter colored tones amongst the body. I'm going to try to show you a female species as well, because the gender dimorphism is pretty high. There we go, right there. You can see what I mean by the nose hasn't pushed out the same way. It's much shorter, doesn't like lean over the mouth, stuff like that. Let's check out that good old Zoopedia for our proboscis. Goes with the Indian elephant and the Malayan tapir, which again, pretty cool. Gonna have to start doing some nice mixed habitats. And here is all the information. Again, if you want to pause, you can, take your time and read this for yourself. They have webbed toes. Fun fact, ladies and gentlemen. Fun fact indeed. Right, number three on our list is the Dole, our canid for the pack. And all of you are in slightly awkward spots, colour-wise, it must be said. There we go. Beautiful stuff. So there is our lovely Dole. Arana, I believe your name is. I think they look really nice in-game. I really do. I know there was a little concern that they were, I think, too pretty, sort of, that the head was too thin, but, you know, they turn out really well. There's some subtle colour variation going on as well. Got those really long tipped ears that you would expect. There's not much for me to say about the Dole, personally. I'm not big on the canids, generally speaking, but I think it's a well-made one. I love the tail and how the colour differentiates and drops down into this deep black. Oh, they're playing. Having the blimmin' time of their lives, they are. Blimmin' time of their lives. I swear, the sun hates me today. Actually, the sun always hates me, but today in particular. Tongue sort of flailing, wagging about. You know, it's got to cool down a little bit. And of course, with an animal like this, that's going to call it a dinosaur, the babies are fairly adorable. To me, it looks like Scrappy-Doo. Which isn't necessarily a good thing. People aren't the biggest fan of Scrappy. But I mean, just look at the little guy. It makes me want a dog so much more. He's absolutely adorable. They might be the cutest babies in the pack, honestly. It's definitely close. Papa, stop ruining it. You see the slightly light in colour as well. They darken as they grow up a little bit. The ears are more rounded, I would say, although still pretty bloody long. But everything else is basically still there. Yeah, screw you, Zebra. That's what he wants. There they are, tongue lolling out, exactly. Endangered again. With only 2,500, which honestly doesn't seem like a lot. That seems like critical, but then critical is like 10 remaining. You know, it's not nice. Some natural habitat stuff, some species data. 25 of them. Big packs of these guys. Research status. Doles are a keystone species. Remember Planet Zoo actually tweeted about that. And no interspecies enrichment for our doles. Fourth on our list is the Binturong. And we do need to talk about this guy for a second. Because, of course, there was a little bit of a lashback, for myself included, when this guy was revealed. Binturong is one of my all-time favourite animals and a very unique and interesting animal. And that didn't really come across in the design. The Binturong has since been fixed, but because this is pre-release, I'm, you know, recording this ahead of time for you guys, so you can get an early access look. Unfortunately, I can't show you the new Binturong, because we're not getting that update early. We're not getting that until tomorrow. So, unfortunately, this is not what the Binturong will look like, but I'll give you a Binturong update video in an hour or so where we'll focus exclusively on the Binturong, and that'll be cool, because you'll be able to compare what you're seeing right now to the Binturong we get in an hour. But I'm going to show you that right now anyway. It is a humongous improvement. You can see the differences in, first of all, the weird ear flaps are gone. This was the main offender, is the bizarre ear flaps, and they are gone. The face shape has been widened and more pointed. The pupils, which are much too large, have been made smaller. And this kind of scraggly hair has been brought in. At the moment, it just kind of looks fluffy, but it looks much scragglier, and the hair's longer at the bottom in the preview image we got. So very, very excited to see what these guys look. We'll see what they look like in-game tomorrow. Which I guess for you guys is in an hour. So I'll show you that very, very soon. I've got to say, there are some nice bits. The tail is really, really good. Doesn't need much changing. The body shape in general is okay. It's just a bit too round. Yeah, there's not much else to say. I will bring you a updated version of the Binturong later on. We'll take a quick look at the baby anyway, just because... because it's a baby! It is kind of adorable. It really is. I don't know if the babies are going to actually change. So, I hope the ears change because they're still there. But it is kind of the cutest thing. Where have you gone, buddy? Let me just... I mean... yeah, it's kind of an adorable little thing, it must be said. The coloration on the baby is actually better than the coloration on the adults, oddly enough. You'd assume the species data won't change though, so we can take a quick look at that for posterity's sake. There we go. So, Binturong. Soon to be changed. Natural habitat, there we go. Only vulnerable, which is nice. My boys are doing okay. Natural habitat, species data, only 2 to 5. Research status. Arcticus means bear weasel. Otherwise, a lot of people call this the cat bear, that's like its colloquial name. And interspecies enrichment with the sun bear and the Malayan tapir, which is pretty cool as well. So you could do one or the other. Maybe wouldn't recommend combining the two, though, must be said. The fifth animal on our list is the Babirusa, a really interesting looking pig animal, essentially, with those incredible tusks that are slowly pointing back towards his own brain. We had slight concerns looking at the trailer, but I mean, the skin texture is phenomenal. Like I say, this is the wrinkly animal pack right here. And the folds and the fat and the way the skin moves and wrinkles on this guy is absolutely top-notch. The horns look fantastic. Babirusa, one of the highest quality animals in the pack for sure. I mean, look at that thing. It's phenomenal. It really is really, really good. Let's go ahead and camera up for a little bit and just see him in action. Just wandering around doing his little piggy things, you know? As people want to do. Females do look fairly different. The females don't have the pronounced tusculature, which is a word I've just invented. As you can see, they've got teeny tiny little tusks. It's actually kind of adorable all in its own way. Look at them. Absolutely tiny. Yeah, I really like this guy. I think the detailing, the way the skin folds here. Look at the little wiggling on the ears there. The ears themselves are beautifully well made, even have that slightly lighter tint inside. The way the skin is sort of folding back around the back base of the skull is really realistic. Little... on the snout, the tail flipping and flapping around. It's a fascinating creature, super weird, which is what I want. I want weird, interesting, unique animals in the park. And the Babirusa is a fantastic example of that. And, to boot, as per usual, the babies are adorable. Because when are the babies in this game not adorable? See if we can fix the lighting on this guy. Oh, there we go. Stop you just for a second there, pal. There he is. Living his best life. You can see they're browner in colour than the parents, which tend to have more greys in them, little hints of pink, but mainly grey. The babies are much more brown in coloration. You know, he's a cocky looking little fella. Or female. In 10. She's a cocky looking little lass, you know? Strolling around doing her thing. Yeah, it's perfect. I don't know what to say about it. So, the Babirusa are vulnerable, 9,999 in the wild, which is very specific. It is specifically the North Sulawesi Babirusa. Natural habitat, I think every animal in this pack, literally everyone, is tropical. It's kind of what you'd expect for Southeast Asia, admittedly. Very low in the requirements, though. Species data 1 to 5, and a bunch of other stuff. Scroll down a little bit, there you go. Research status, Babirusa means pig deer in Malay. There you go. And no interspecies enrichment. They're lone pigs doing their own thing. I got rid of the water because they wouldn't stop getting wet, basically. I don't know what else to say. They just decided to live in the water and it's hard to showcase them. Just look at that. I mean, fantastic detailing. It really is. Absolutely fantastic. Let's move on. 3 animals left to go. We are going to go for the Malayan tapir next, which has one of the best signs, it must be said. There you go. That's the big sign, the little babby signs. Actually, I'll show you them all very quickly. My apologies. There's the dole. There's the sun bear, which has both a tongue and a non-tongue variant. There's a proboscis one, which is slightly unusual, to say the least. And over here somewhere, yep, there's our... Not the greatest lighting for it, but there's our binturong. Bit of an odd one as well, very cool. We don't have one right now for the Babirusa. That might be here by tomorrow, but it isn't in our current version of the game. But the Babirusa is the animal, as you can see from this lovely little statue over here. This happy little Babirusa. That's the new time scenario rewards a Babirusa statue, which is cool. Anyways, tapir time. There we go, our Malayan tapir, featuring that very, very well-known coloration. That big split between the black and the white. They are basically cow-patterned, essentially. And, it looks like a Malayan tapir. I know there are issues with their head and skull shape more than anything else. People do think this is basically a bear tapir reskin, essentially, when the animals are not identical. I'm not going to get too much into that in this video. We will have a Malayan tapir habitat in our park build, which will start tonight, by the way, hopefully. And maybe we'll talk about it then, but if you're, you know, a little bit more casual... Like myself with tapirs, I think you just think, yeah, it looks like a Malayan tapir. It's fine. I like it. It's cute. Got a little ear flick going on, little nodule bit there. Of course, it's pooping because it's on a Best and Slot YouTube video. And that's what they do. And yeah, I mean, the patterning is very striking. That coloration is very decidedly Malayan tapir, and you can see it from miles away. It really sticks out. It's really cool in that regard. Maybe the skull could be better proportioned and shaped, and, you know, the snout could be reworked a little bit. Oh, but it's a nice animal. It is. I'm in a good mood. They fixed the binturong, so I'm just happy, you know. I know some people have issues with it, and it feels it feels silly to not mention that those exist, but at the same time, I won't say that it's one that personally bothers me, you know. And that is doubly so for the babies, because they're adorable. Don't know why when I say the word babies, I go, babies. But they are super, super cute. The patterning on the babies is fantastic. Again, very similar to the Baird's tapir in some ways. It's interesting that baby tapirs, even if the adults look completely different, the babies have similarities. But yeah, the patterning's lovely. You know, the striping's really pronounced. It's super interesting how this turns into that. The difference in coloration and patterning is extreme, to say the least. You know, we've even got this. Oh, they sounded so cute. Got this faded portion at the back, these darker colours, and lots of speckling going on as well. Oh yeah! He's the freaking Kool-Aid guy. He just barged in going, oh yeah! Let's check out some details for the tapir. Oh god, alright, so you can see the beds. I just wanted to look at the beds. Show you the babies so I can make my point. Yeah, so I think it is literally the same body shape, but is what it is. So, Malayan tapir, endangered natural habitat, a little bit more contained down in Southeast Asia. Species data, only 1 to 2, not very sociable animals, must be said. They are the larger species of tapir, which is nice if you're into big tapirs. And lots of interspecies enrichment if you're into that as well, which, you know, you should be, because interspecies enrichment is awesome. Right, the final habitat animal on our list with these double signs we've got here, just different sort of sizes, there you go, is of course the clouded leopard. Definitely a fan favourite, just because people love cute cats, to say the least. Yeah, really cool again. I'm just going to freeze you right there if you don't mind, pal, so people can get a good look at you. There we go. Beautiful little critter. Love that. I mean, that fur looks absolutely perfect. It's so good. And the depth in the eyes. I mean, I don't know how to say eyes in that sort of vaguely creepy way, but I want to... Real. They look like a cat's eyes. It's very cool. Zoom back out. There we go. Yeah, it's a great looking animal. It's got... I want to see it open its jaw. You know, clouded leopard is well known for having this almost... Don't know what you're doing there, but oh my god. For having this Smilodon-esque jaw when it can open its mouth very, very wide. Thank you. I thought you were going to poop, and I'm very proud of you. You know, cleaning itself a little bit. The patterning is beautiful. I mean, especially around the chest there. The way these different black shapes sort of blend together with the lighter greys and the whites and the darker greys is really interesting looking. There we go. Nice wide open jaw there. Lovely stuff. And you can see a little bit colour variation. See, this one is quite pale in coloration, whereas this one over here, much more orange and yellow and golden in its tones. But that quite a lot of clouded leopards are much more like this. They're kind of golden in colour. And some are definitely like this. So it's really nice that we've got that differentiation between the two. Because, I mean, that is pronounced. You can see that from a mile away. There's that big jaw again. Let me just grab that. Very cool. I might have to grab a thumbnail screenshot, actually. Yeah, adorable. Really beautiful patterning. Slightly demon tongue there for a second. Even the tail itself, you know, just perfect. They nailed it, honestly. Like, I'm being very positive, but... The animals in this pack are top tier. It is, in my opinion, easily the best pack we've had. Oh, calm down, pal. And then there's the baby, which, as you would expect, for a small cat, is also fairly adorable. Let's move you over here. Sorry, pal. I'm going to pause you for a sec so the good people at home can get a good look. Hello, little baby. I don't know what else to say when I see them. They're super cute. They're very similar to their parents, I would say. The patterning is still very developed in there. It's interesting because they're like, you know, these leopard spots that then fade out very distinctly on one side towards the head. And then at the tail, they kind of round out and fill in a little bit more. And it's like that on the parents as well. It's just a cute little big-eyed version of its parents, basically. It's great. There's another one clambering down. Oh, good job, buddy. Proud of you. And some people are going to love this guy. This is one of those animals that... Oh, da-da, oh, oh. They've never quite got the jumping and climbing quite figured out, but it's okay. You can excuse a few things here and there. And, you know, generally speaking, it's working pretty well. Anyways, that is all of our habitat animals. Oh, no, excuse me. We should check out the clouded leopard. We wouldn't expect any species mixing. General information, adorable. Vulnerable, 10,000 in the wild. Natural habitat, quite spread out, I would say, in Asia, generally speaking. Species data, just 1 to 2. Promiscuous, though. Uh-oh. Research status, there you go. And finally, interspecies enrichment, which we've already seen. It's nothing. I do want to check very quickly, are any of these animals guest enterable? That's not the sentence I wanted to say. So probably, as you would expect, the only animal that has a walkthrough element to it is the binturong. And that's going to be quite nice, a walk-through Binturong habitat with those new updated Binturongs. You'd have a very popcorn-smelling habitat, and that's the dream, quite frankly. Right, that is it for our habitat animals. They do look good from a distance, don't they? They really do. I love the coloration. But we do have one more animal to showcase, and that is our Malaysian leaf insect. So let's find one. We have many thousands of them, because they just breed like crazy, like all the other exhibit animals. And let me see if we can just track one down here before I... Nope, can't see it. This is the problem. it's on the leaf, oddly enough. Alright, cool. We just need to edit the sunlight slightly. Beautiful. And we're going to hop in on our Ansel camera. It's really the only way to view these things properly. And there it is. So you get a nice little field of view in, shall we? Nice little look at the details on this thing, which are staggering. I mean, look at the veins crossing over from that leaf. The fact that this is on an exhibit animal is utterly bizarre, but I really, really appreciate it. The edges, as I mentioned on the leaf the other day, they've all got this sort of burnt sort of look to them, very much like a lot of natural leaves where they've been chewed down by animals. The eyes are terrifying, quite frankly. Absolutely terrifying, but there they are. They look like sweets wrapped up. I'm not expecting much movement from these guys, it must be said. They're not doing anything. I mean, it wants to look like a leaf at the end of the day. Let's see if we can find one more. Is that one down there? Yep, there's another one. Oh, my God. I've lost myself. I don't know where I am in my life. There we go. There's another one for you over there as well. They're pretty cool. There you go. Just chilling. They're not very exciting. When you've looked at them once, you're kind of done, to be honest. But they are remarkably well made. Right, so that is all 8 of the brand new animals. I will say, in terms of animal quality, this is the best pack we've ever had, in my opinion. Well, it will be when the Binturong gets fixed. That was the one thing holding the pack down, and of course that is no longer the case. The new Binturong looks fantastic, and we'll do a full... I mean, it'll only be a short video, but we'll do a showcase on that in an hour or so when the new update hits. But yeah, I'm actually really impressed. I don't think, maybe other than the tapir, to an extent, if you're going to be picky about it, I don't really think there's a weak animal in the pack anymore. I think it's really, really good. I'm a little sad we don't have loads of decorations, because that's what I like about the game, personally. But I know for so many of you at home playing this game, more animals is better, so, you know, it's fine. You know, we've got to appeal to different people, and I get them. And not too sad about it, really. We have plenty of great stuff to use for a Southeast Asian-inspired park, no matter what. So, a quick ranking from myself. The new Binturong is going to take number one. I hesitate to put it there now because I haven't seen it in-game, but it is going to take number one, so I'm going to put it there anyway. Binturong number one, Sunbear number two, Babirusa number three. This is on my personal enjoyment of the animal, not their quality. Number four would be probably the Clouded Leopard. Number five would be the Proboscis. Number six would be the Dole. Number seven would be the Tapir. God, I might put the tapir above the doll. I just don't particularly enjoy canids. Yeah, I'm going to put tapir 6th, doll 7th. I might put the tapir above the monkey as well. We'll see. And 8th place would be the insect. And the insect is, in terms of quality, probably the second or third best in the entire thing, if not the best. But it's an exhibit animal at the end of the day, so there's only so much enjoyment I can get from it. It's a really good pack. Later on today or tomorrow, hopefully tonight though, we'll be starting a brand new Southeast Asian inspired zoo with all 8 of these animals included, plus at least one more. I do have a gharial exhibit planned as well, just because I had an idea and I thought I have to get it out there. We're going to be doing some very, very cool stuff. We're going to have a boat tour going on, we have some crazy habitats, we're going to have some chill habitats. It's going to be another Planet Zoo speed build series, all Southeast Asia inspired. So I hope you stick around for that. There's a playlist for that link down below in the description. I'll see you guys here in an hour or so for the Binturong update. And then tonight, hopefully, like I say, brand new zoo build. I'll see you lovely folks there. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye.